Dear students, today we will discuss quick sort algorithm. So selection sort, insertion sort and bubble sort you have already discussed. So now you take this quick sort algorithm and see by an example how it works. See, here I have 8 elements stored in an array from 0 to 7. In quick sort algorithm, we make this first element as a pivot element. Pivot means a point around which the whole work will be done. So this 30 becomes a pivot element. The first element of array, location 0. So this is pivot element. I have marked it with red. Now what we will do, we will start one index I from this side, left to right. And we will search for an element greater than pivot element. So wherever I find an element greater than pivot, I will stop. So I started at 1. So I stopped here only because it is greater than pivot element. Similarly, I will also move some j equals to 7 initially. And I will come from right to left, j minus minus. So I will come backside. I will decrease j and I will find an element which is lesser than this pivot element. I will stop. So I started from j equals to 7. This is not lesser than this pivot element. So I came at 6 and I stopped here. So I have marked this j equals to I equals to 1. I stopped and j equals to 6. I stopped. Then what I'll do, I will swap these two elements. So 17 will come here, 54 will go here. Now again you move ahead. I plus plus, that means I will move from left to right. And what you are finding? An element greater than pivot element. So you stop here, I equals to 2. And from left, from right side, you are moving left. So j is minus minus. So you find an element smaller than pivot. So this is smaller than pivot. So you stop here. So j equals to 5, I equals to 2. These two elements you have stopped and then you will swap them. So 22 is here, 42 is here now. Then repeat this process. I will move ahead, I plus plus. So this element is greater than pivot element. So I equals to 3, you stop here. And j equals to 4, 25. So this is smaller than this pivot element. So j is searching for a smaller element. So j stopped here, j equals to 4. And then you swap these two elements. Now again, keep going. So I equals to 4. Here you will find the element greater than this pivot element. And j equals to 3. Now j equals to 3. Because the element which is less than pivot is here. Now we will not swap. When I is greater than j, this c I equals to 4 and j equals to 3. So when I is equals to greater than j, it means I and j have crossed each other. I was moving from left to right, j was moving from right to left. They have crossed each other. So we will not swap I and j. Instead of that, what we will do, we will swap jth position, j equals to 3. So this jth position and this pivot element will be swapped. Remember, when I crosses j, that means I becomes greater than j. We will not swap I and j, we will swap jth element and the pivot element. So pivot will come here. By doing this exercise, what you have observed, you can see that our list of 8 elements is now divided into 2 sublists. We will call them left sublist and right sublist. So this is pivot element, this is left sublist and this is right sublist. You can also see that all the elements in left sublist are smaller than pivot element and all elements in right sublist are greater than the pivot element. So this process which we have done is called partitioning. So we have partitioned the list in two sublists. One contains elements lesser than the pivot, and other contains elements greater than the pivot element. So what is the key idea behind quicksort algorithm? Recursive partitioning of the list. That means that you have partitioned once. So your problem was from 0 to 7. You have broken it at 3. So now you have two smaller problems, from 0 to 2 and from 4 to 7. So you will repeat the same process for this sub problem, this smaller problem 0 to 2. And you will also repeat the process for this sub problem 4 to 7. So this problem will also be partitioned, and this problem will also be partitioned. So recursive partitioning means we will keep doing that until unless there is a single element in each list. So this is a sublist. Ultimately, this will also be broken into two lists. So ultimately, you will get list of one element which is already sorted. And in that manner, this algorithm will sort the elements. Here you see the code for partitioning algorithm. So if it is assumed that array A is globally declared when you write a C program, then integer A, L and H. So you will tell from which index L to what index H you want to partition the array. So I want to partition the array from L to H. This is required because sometimes we will partition from 0 to 2, sometimes we will partition from 4 to 7, sometimes we will partition from 0 to 7 also. So L to H we want to partition. So how you did this partitioning? You moved I from left to right, you moved J from right to left. Initial value of I was L plus 1. So wherever L starts, I equals to L plus 1, J equals to H, the last element. The pivot element is the first element of list because list starts at L. So it is P equals to AL. Then you keep swapping and moving I and J until unless I is less than J. So while I is less than J, you move I plus plus. While AI is less than P, you will move it. P is the pivot element. So until unless there is a smaller element, you will do I plus plus. If greater element, you will stop. Here, you move the J from right to left, J minus minus. So if AJ is greater than P, then you will keep moving. J will decrease. But if AJ is less than P, then you will stop. And then you will swap AI and AJ. So AI and AJ will be swapped. So this is done. I have not shown here, it is conditional swap. So you must show a condition here. If I is less than J, then perform this swap. Otherwise, please don't perform this swap. So if I is less than J, swap those elements. And when I will become less than J, I is less than J, this loop will keep working. When I is greater than J, this loop will stop. At that time, you will swap the lth element and jth element, as I have told you in the example, and then you return the value of J. So this code is only for partitioning, and this also requires here to put an if I is less than J, then swap, else no action. So this is the partitioning code. The quicksort algorithm code is recursive partitioning. So quicksort algorithm takes array is global, low to high. So initially it will be 0 and n minus 1. If low is less than high, it will partition from low to high, and then will quicksort call itself low to J minus 1. J is the point where the partition is performed, and quicksort J plus 1 to high. So you try this sorting algorithm on your laptop. Also try to write the algorithm itself, write the program, run it, do some exercise manually, how to partition, So this is about quickshot algorithm. Thank you very much.